The next question of unit number 5 and also last question in this unit, the last big question. What are carbon nanotubes? Explain their properties and application in detail. Carbon nanotubes, 16 mark question. So, to explain in detail about the carbon tubes construction and also their different application, various properties of the particular one in detail. Yes. So first go to the particular part. What is carbon nanotubes? The definition. It is a large tube like structure. It is a large tube like structure made up of graphene. What is graphene? Graphene is a allotropy of carbon. Allotropy of carbon. So once again I define it. What is carbon nanotubes? Nano already explained. It is dimension is very small, of the order of nanometer. So we can make it by the help of nano tubes and so many other structure. We use these everything in a different field. So nanotubes all manufactured with the help of the atoms. The help of the atoms. That atoms are synthesized in various method. That method is also going to be explained in this particular question in detail. So it is a large tube like structure made up of graphene carbon, that is nanoparticle. Graphene nothing but allotropy of carbon, and various nature is there, application everything is there. First our focus is towards how to make these nanotubes and what are the different types of nanotubes available, everything is made. Actually nanotubes are made up of fullerene structure. This is similar to fullerene structure. Nanotubes are the member of nanotube is a member of fullerene structure. What is fullerene? Fullerene already the explanation is given in the previous class also. Fullerene is a carbon arrangement in the form of spherical. The arrangement of carbon in the form of spherical, and also particularly 60 atoms are arranged to form like a volleyball, that ball like structure, that we called fullerene. So this nanotube is a member of fullerene. Now the question is there. Nanotube means it is a cylindrical size. How to equate this tube with that fullerene? That's why I told you. Fullerene already I told, this is a actually spherical form, have 60 carbon atoms, the arrangement of carbon atom that form spherical shape. But carbon nanotube is a member of fullerene. Nanotube is not in the spherical form, it is a cylindrical form. The spherical fullerene are known as buckyballs. Once again, spherical fullerene is also called by the name of buckyball. Buckyball, B-U-C-K-Y, buckyball. This is actual fullerene. Spherical fullerene is named as buckyball. This is not nanotubes. Once again, it's not a nanotubes. Nanotubes are not in shape of ball. It is a tube-like form. It is a linear form. A spherical fullerene is named as buckyball. The same way, a cylindrical shape, cylindrical one, cylindrical, the arrangement of atoms or everything in the spherical means that we called buckyball. That fullerene is known as the buckyball. If it is in the cylindrical form, that we called bucky tubes or this particular nanotubes. Bucky tubes or this particular nanotubes. So now there is a clarity about the nanotubes, and that made up of atoms, carbon, actually carbon nanotubes made up of carbon atoms, number of carbon atoms. That is also, it is in the fullerene family. Everything I explain. Then the nanotubes, particularly carbon nanotubes, have two different types. One is single walled carbon nanotube, single walled carbon nanotube. Then another one is multi-walled, single walled carbon nanotube and multi-walled carbon nanotube. So like that, two different types. How many types of nanotubes available? That is two different types available. That is, one is single walled and another one is multi-walled. Now we move to explain about the single walled and multi-walled. What is the meaning of single walled? Single walled means single walled carbon nanotubes. Single walled carbon nanotubes, which has only single, that's having single layer, that is single sheet of atoms. Single sheet of atoms that is rolled in the form of nanotubes. It whose width is in the range in between 1 and 3 nanometer. The range of this tube is in between 1 and 3 nanometer. Then multi-walled carbon nanotubes having multiple sheet of carbon atoms. Multiple sheet of carbon atom that is rolled, that form a multi-walled carbon nanotube, whose size, the diameter of the multi-walled that means the carbon nanotube is greater than 3 nanometer. So very important point is, single walled carbon nanotubes which have a single sheet of carbon atoms having the diameter that is one, in between 1 and 3 nanometer. More than 1, that means sheet of carbon atoms available, means that they belong to multi-walled carbon nanotubes, where whose size or whose diameter is greater than 3 nanometer. That's next, three distinct way which the graphene sheet can be rolled to form this tube. Already told, a fullerene that can be rolled. Spherical form is not a nanotubes. If it is in the form of cylindrical, that we called nanotubes anyway. So different shape arrangement of carbon atoms, everything is rolled. That roll, after rolling only, rolled to make like a cylinder, then only that we called nanotubes. So even different shape arrangement of carbon atoms, everything is rolled in the form of tube like structure, then only we named it is carbon nanotube. So that's why I explained the previous fullerene. Actual fullerene in the spherical form is not a nanotube. If it is in the cylinder, if it made by the way of cylindrical means, we called it is nanotubes. So the structure, anyway, the three distinct way that we have this type of graphene, that is graphene sheet, and be rolled to form these tubes. The first one is the first the way of rolling to rolling that carbon arrangement to form this, that is a graphene sheet that can be rolled to form the carbon nanotube. The three distinct ways are there. One is the arm, that means arm chair, that means structure, arm chair structure. The second one is zigzag structure. Then the third one is chiral structure, that is armchair structure, zigzag structure, chiral structure. How these structures are classified? The classification is based on the rolling. When you are rolling that graphene sheet, the graphene sheet is rolled to make a carbon tubes. In the rolling pattern, based on the rolling pattern, carbon nanotube structure is classified into three different types. Three different ways by which we make the carbon nanotubes from these, graphene. First one is armchair structure, zigzag structure, chiral structure. So what is the meaning of armchair structure? Very easy. When the axis of the tube, if this is axis of tube, then arrangement of carbon atom is like arrangement of carbon atoms, that is look like in this way. So look at this axis of tube is parallel to carbon bond. The axis of tube is, if the axis of nanotube, the tube is parallel to carbon bond, that arrangement, that structure, we named it is armchair structure. Then zigzag structure, this, suppose this is an axis of tube, if that arrangement of carbon bond is like this, that means which is perpendicular to the tubes, the perpendicular to the particular tube means we can get it like this. So the arrangement is different. So look at this, the arrangement of carbon bond that is arranged perpendicular to this axis of tube, then that structure named as zigzag structure. Then the last one is, that is chiral structure, nothing but suppose this is an axis of tube in which the arrangement of carbon, that means carbon bond, that is arranged, that is shifted towards the axis of tube. The arrangement of atoms are shifted towards the axis of tube. So the arrangement is like this. So in this case parallel, here it is perpendicular to axis of the tube. Now here this arrangement of carbon bond, everything is shifted towards the axis of the tube. Why it is shifted? So actual arrangement is look like this arrangement. So here this arrangement, but now this, there is a shift towards the axis of the tube. So such kind of the arrangement of carbon to carbon bond that we called chiral structure. So these are the different structure or different array, different way of arranging the carbon atoms that is available in a carbon nanotubes. In such a way, the carbon nanotubes are made by rolling that the already called it is that means fullerene, and also that means another one structure is there. So the arms, the armchair structure, zigzag structure, chiral structure, that's all the different way based on different way of rolling. The after rolling we can get this nano tubes. Now we move to the synthesis of carbon nanotube. Synthesis, how to make this carbon nanotubes? Synthesis of carbon nanotubes. What are the way? What are the methods available to achieve such kind of carbon nanotubes by experiment? So the different methods. First one is arc method. This is one method. Arc method is the first method to, by this way we can make the carbon nanotubes. The second one is pulsed laser deposition method. Pulsed laser deposition method. Then the last one is chemical vapor deposition method. Chemical vapor deposition method. So what are the synthesis to make how these carbon nanotubes are synthesized? We have different method, that is arc method, pulsed laser deposition method, then the third one is chemical vapor deposition. So now we move to that method by one by one, and how can produce such kind of nanotubes experimentally. So now we move to the first one, that means arc method. Arc method is going to be find out. The first one is arc method. Arc method is a one method. By this way, a carbon nanotubes are going to be produced. That means arc method is a first method to, by this way the carbon nanotubes are produced experimentally. Experimental production we are talking about. For that, here we have two electrodes, that carbon electrodes. These two electrodes are separated by 1 millimeter. The separation is actually 1 millimeter. Then here, with the help of suitable arrangement, the inert gas is provided. Inert gas like that is helium or argon, like inert gas is going to be supplied by this way, and here the waste gas is going to be taken out. This is the waste gas. Here it is inert gases. Now these two electrodes are going to be connected to a battery. Then now this electrode is named as anode. Here it is named as cathode. It is cathode, is connected to negative terminal, this connected to positive terminal. Now with the help of a suitable application of voltage, nearly 20 to 25 volt, 20 to 25 voltage, when we apply this voltage, there is a formation of emission of carbon atoms. The formation of or emission of carbon atoms that taken from that particular anode, and these emitted atoms all deposited on cathode. From this, carbon atoms are emitted, and emitted atoms are going to be deposited on the surface of cathode like a carbon nanotubes. Carbon that form the carbon nanotubes. When potential is continuously applied, then carbon deposition over the negative terminal is going to be increases, which result the formation of the carbon nanotubes. The deposited purified and single walled based after purification, we can get a single walled after purification, single walled carbon nanotube is going to be obtained by this way. So by this way we can get carbon nanotubes, that is single walled carbon nanotubes. So first we think like that. So atoms only is liberated, atoms only going to be liberated, yes, atom only liberated as continuous voltage, high voltage is provided, this atom deposited over this negative terminal, as a result of that carbon nanotubes will be formed. This experiment number one, that is arc method. By this method the carbon nanotubes are going to be produced. That next one is pulsed laser. Second one is pulsed laser method. So now we move to the demonstration, how to produce this. First we are going to see about the that means constructed diagram. So okay, pulsed laser deposition method. So now we move to the diagram part. The diagram part of pulsed laser deposition is first here it is a laser source. This is nothing but laser source. So here the laser beam is needed. So the laser beam is going to be produced from this one laser source. Then from this laser source, the laser light will be come out. The laser light is going to be focused with the help of the lens. Okay, then lens is going to be used. This light is going to be fall on a mirror which is inclined 45 degree. A mirror which is inclined 45 degree angle, 45 degree. Then automatically it move the downward direction. Here the first one shutter is there. This is nothing but shutter. Then after passing through this shutter, once again this laser light will be come out, and that can be focused with the help of focusing lens. Focusing lens is a kind of lens that is going to be focused. Then after that also the same will be come out. Here one electrode is there, that we called window, that is named as window. And finally it emerges or it enter into evacuated chamber. Evacuated chamber means gases are removed, but after that some inert gases are filled. The inert gases like argon gas is going to be filled in this particular one, and also in the middle part of this one graphite is there. This is graphite. So anyway, this laser is finally fall on this graphite, and this below this graphite one part is there where the copper collector part. This is a copper collector part is available in the lower end where the carbon atoms are going to be deposited. Copper collector rod. So over this copper collector rod the tubes are formed. So now look at this pulsed laser deposition experiment arrangement. Here we have one small, that means container like part, that part fully occupied by carbon gas, sorry, argon gas, inert gas. Then the middle of this one graphite is there. Then below this graphite, a copper collector rod is there. Then then here also a high electrical power, that means electric power is available, electric power is provided here. This electric power is provided between these polarities of this particular case, that is quartz tube. So once again, this is quartz tube, this is a quartz tube. So here the argon gas, this is quartz tube in which graphite is middle part. Below this graphite, copper collector, that is rod, everything is there. So this is a construction, this electric high electrical field is provided. So what is the method indicate, or by this way how can produce these carbon nanotubes, that is going to be explained. That means here this graphite contain, that means that particular first one is quartz in which graphite is there. The graphite is continuously focused by this electricity, that means electric furnace. What is mean by furnace? The furnace is a part in which extremely high heat is going to be produced. So the continuously high heat is produced in this part. That produced heat is enter into this quartz area, and so that graphite is going to be evaporated. So from the graphite, carbon atoms are going to be come out. So carbon atoms are come out from the graphite. In addition of that, laser sources also produces laser light that is focused on the graphite. So anyway, at last, large number of carbon atoms are come out from the graphite, that all deposited on this particular copper collector rod. So at the end, on that copper collector rod, the large number of carbon atoms are continuously deposited. So as a result of that, carbon nanotubes were formed. So this is the one way. So these all experimental way, experimental point of view, these all possible in that laboratory. So this everything, every arrangements are available in the laboratory, well equipped laboratory. So from that we are able to make it this in that research purpose, research time, researchers going to be produces these like this type of carbon nanotube in order for the betterment of the different that means devices, and also the identification of different properties of nanotubes, everything. So this is a second method by this that means the carbon nanotube is going to be produced. Now we move to the third one, the third method by this carbon nanotubes are going to be manufactured. That means the third one is chemical vapor deposition method. That means the last one. Here also we have the arrangement, this arrangement in which one substrate is there. The substrate is there, then over the next in this part here one opening is there, in this part is also another one opening is there. This is inlet tube through which we allowed two gases, that means CH4 and also N2, nitrogen and also CH for these two also allowed to enter into that inlet. Then outlet is also there. Outlet, as there is a last in the outlet, here the carbon nanotubes are going to be deposited. Here this is a this is particular case substrate that is substrate, and here also the in furnaces are there, induction furnace or anyway the furnace is there in order to produces a heavy heat. In order to produces a heavy heat, here the furnace is going to be furnaces when you are injected the gases, reaction gas through this inlet. What are the reaction gases? CH4 and N2 that enter into this vacuum chamber, where this in this particular furnace which produces 1100 degree Celsius, extremely high temperature, 1100 degree Celsius is going to be maintained in this particular part with the metal substrate. So now the gas is allowed to enter into this part. So due to extremely high temperature, carbon is going to be separated out of this CH4 and N2. Carbon atoms are going to be separated. These carbon atoms are going to be deposited on the cooler part. This is extremely hot. This is the cooler part. So the cooler part, these carbon atoms are going to be deposited. As a result, continuous carbon atom deposition, here we can get the carbon nanotube. So this is another, the third method, chemical vapor deposition method. So these are the different method by this way the carbon nanotubes are obtained with the help by the help of the experiment. So next we are going to see about this properties of particular carbon nanotubes. What are the different properties? Carbon nanotubes are actually general properties, are different properties are there, mechanical property, physical property, chemical properties, everything. So first we going to see about the physical properties. Physical properties, it is a high strength material, so which are going to, whose value is 100 times greater than that of the steel. Nanotubes, name is nanotubes, but whose strength is extremely high, 100 times greater than that of the steel. That is a physical strength of that particular nanotube. That's why the nanotubes are made. These nanotubes are going to be used in many devices. Because of its strength, the surface area is larger. So different properties are there, physical properties. Then mechanical properties, as usual, strength, related to strength, it is very high strength, and which is withstand. Nanotubes are withstand against the high strain, going to withstand the high strain. Then the chemical properties. Or move to the chemical properties. What are the chemical properties of the particular one? It is difficult to oxidation. Because of high strength and other factor, it is very difficult to oxidation. So that's one very important chemical properties, and that is high resistance. It have high resistance. So that is also under this chemical properties categories. Then also electrical properties. In that electrical properties, it is high electrical conductivity. Carbon nanotubes are high electrical conductivity. Then carbon nanotubes are metallic, that is, or semi-conducting, depend on the diameter of this particular tube. The tube, based on the tube diameter, you can classify it in the metallic form or the semiconductor categories. That's all. The next, the thermal properties. The thermal properties, it has a high thermal conductivity. Already told, it is high electrical conductivity. Like that, thermal conductivity also high thermal conductivity. Then application of this one. Application is large scale electrical devices, electronic devices. are going to be produced. Large scale of electronic devices are going to be produced by using this particular nanotubes, that is carbon nanotubes. Then further, what about the other uses or particularly application? Because of lightweight, they can used in that aerospace. Because of lightweight, they are used in aerospace. Aerospace part we can use nanotubes, or sometime we use as a catalyst in some places. And these also used in the fuel cells and electrodes. These are used in electrodes and sometime fuel cells, everything. So many applications are there. So many applications are there with the help of it. That's why the new field nowadays, most of the research is in the field of nanotubes, in order to attain strength material and for producing the high strength devices in such large area. These nano materials and nano physics is going to be very useful. So by this we conclude this unit 5 question answer, everything. So study well then. Thank you.